What is object-oriented programming? What is object-oriented design? And what is object-oriented analysis? Hello friends, today we'll be discussing what is object-oriented programming is, and what is object-oriented design, and what is object-oriented analysis. We will first take the definitions from object-oriented analysis and design from Grady Bush. This is one of the best book. I would say it is a object-oriented analysis and design bible from the Grady Bush. It is one of the very old and one of the best book available on the topic. So what is object-oriented programming? First, we'll go into the definition of object-oriented programming. Object-oriented programming is a method of implementation in which programs are organized as cooperative collection of objects, each of which represent an instance of some class and whose classes are all members of a hierarchy of classes united by inheritance relationship. So it could be, let's take an example of airplane. It could be made of different objects. It has engine, it has tail fin. So at the top level, they may inherit all from airplane components. They may be made of same material. So they have some common properties, methods that can go into airplane components. And there we drive engine, landing gear, a tail fin, all different components of the airplane. And from engine, there could be engine, jet engine, propeller engine, different kind of, there could be different kind of engines. So we can see there are objects and they work, they cooperate with each other and they have some kind of hierarchy. They are inherited from some class, like engine one is derived from engine class kind of. One thing is important is like individual, how the object-oriented programming works. When object works together, they send messages to each other, they work as a unit. Like each component of airplane may fall apart, but together they make the airplane fly. So what is object-oriented design? Object-oriented design is a method of design encompassing the process of object-oriented decomposition and a notation for depicting both logical and physical, as well as static and dynamic models of the system under design. So what it means, like we have different classes, airplane, engine, that is more a static view. The dynamic view of could be, if you come from the UML, it could be a sequence diagram, object diagram. I have never used object diagram, activity diagram. So these are all examples of dynamic. Like engine could be stopped on the airfield, but when it's flying, it is in the running state. That is the dynamic state. So we use UML for showing the model for the class diagram. So if you are experienced diagram, lot of time you may just create objects, classes, you may create classes, drive objects, and have some kind of hierarchy and make them work together. But if you are working a big team, you are new to object-oriented programming, you want to communicate your model, even if you are experienced, if some other group is using your object model, your service, so you need to have some kind of diagrams, some blueprints showing your what are your object model is, what is your service, how they are going to use the APIs. So that is object-oriented design. Now let's come to object-oriented analysis. Object-oriented analysis is a method of analysis that examines requirement from the perspective of the class and object found in the vocabulary of the problem domain. So in the airplane, we have engine, we have landing gear, we have a cockpit, So we have to find out what are the different components in the airplane, and how they work together, what are their functions. So that is object-oriented analysis, and now it's very popularly known as domain-driven design. There are a lot of literature on domain-driven design. I have some videos. I'll put the link on the top or the bottom. I do have playlist on domain-driven design. If you are new to domain-driven design, do watch that.
Thanks for watching this video. My name is Vikas Kerni. I have more than 20 years of experience in IT industry. I am TOGAF certified architect. Do subscribe to my channel for your regular updates.